all creative people need courage to do something different. Her artist lagatar yahi koshish karta rehta hai ki wo kuch alag kare. Catherine Bernard is one artist who neither lacks in creativity nor the guts to do something different.
Missouri. I grew up there. I always painted and made drawings as a child. And then I went to art school, Art Institute of Chicago, and I studied painting there, and I did like the advanced painting program there. And then directly after that, I got into the graduate school in New York, School of Visual Arts. So then I moved to New York, and that was 2 years. So now I've been out of school, and I've been in New York about 10 years painting still. My paintings are celebrities and models, and musicians and entrepreneurs, and they're all, I find them, I go through magazines like Elle and Vogue and Suede, and I go through like fashion magazines, and I go through and I find pictures and ads of models and people that I like, and I tear it out, and then I make a painting from it.
Catherine paints portraits of women, mainly celebrities and models she admires, in a very different way. Catherine's paintings have a raw, rustic energy about them. Raccoon eyes, red pouty lips, frozen expressions, undone hair. This is how she interprets the usually picture-perfect porcelain models. Acrylic, specialty paints or glitter ko abstract tarike se use karna unka trademark style hai.
My paintings are probably made out of like anger and aggression and like things like that, but like I don't hate the models or the people or anything. They just come out kind of aggressive like that, because that's how I am. It's like my personality directly on the canvas.
A true artist leaves the viewer spellbound and inspired. So let's meet some of the art lovers and find out what they thought about her paintings.
My name is Tariq Dejani, and I'm a commercial and art photographer in Dubai.
Christy. Rosanna.
I'm Kurosh Nuri. I'm the director of Carbon 12.
This is new kind of stuff. I've only been in Dubai for about a year and a half, but this is very new from anything that I've seen here. It's certainly very American, and it's very New York in style.
I think it's the brushstrokes. I think it's just, it's like really fast, and it's it just really, you really understand what celebrity, you know, celebrity is all about, like being modern, and you're in the limelight 1 minute and then you're out of it the next minute, and it kind of expresses that through her strokes. And no, I love it. It's really good.
She's an amazing New Yorker artist. She's one of the stars of today and probably even bigger tomorrow. She is, I would say, definitely one of our one of the stars of our heart, basically. We love what she does since many years. And I must say, I'm so proud to show such an exhibition in Dubai.
I like them. For me, they're a little bit too strong, and the colors are very, very vivid. But I can see that the attraction that they would have for a lot of people.
I think they're wicked. They're really energetic, and yeah, they capture like the key kind of characteristics of all the celebrities and stuff. So yeah, really, really good.
And I think having them in a setting like this, which is very much like a New York apartment style setting, is perfect.
I absolutely love them. I think they're brilliant. They're really fashion, really now. I love them. Really good.
In my opinion, this is one of the best shows she has ever done, you know? And luckily, like the reaction of the people is very positive, and basically, it's great to have an artist of this caliber coming here.
Catherine ki dramatic paintings dekhne ke baad, it's time for us to see something striking and bohemian. Well, I'm talking about Bo Chic, the jewelry brand that recently showcased their latest collection in Dubai.
Bo Chic was founded in 2004. And basically, it's a marriage of two designers, David Joseph, and my wife, Miriam Salat. We started designing for the beau chic woman. It's the idea of a woman who is very sophisticated, chic, well-traveled. And we get our inspiration from what we call the Old Orient, which is Middle East, India, Old Spain, some Moorish influence to it. And we give it a modern twist. We work with a range of celebrity clients. Some of them are actresses, and Angelina Jolie, Halle Berry, Sandra Bullock, Scarlett Johansson, Jada Pinkett Smith. I mean, there is quite a few of them.
It was a glamorous event, and we got to meet some top jewelry designers from Hong Kong, Lebanon, and Italy.
My name is Aisha Gul, and our company is a family company. It's called Topal. And we're manufacturers and retailers of jewelry. It's all handmade jewelry. And what we brought here is very special and unique pieces that are, as I told you, all handmade and, you know, one-of-a-kind pieces. The most important collection that we have here today is actually a first in the world. We have taken an Arab-originated artist's pictures and we have turned them into jewelry, which is never done before. So all pieces are unique and each have a specific painting, you know, that goes with it, and each has a different story.
My name is Cindy Chow, I'm from Taiwan. I'm trying to design some of the jewelry to touch people's heart. For me, jewelry is like a second face for a woman. So this is something I'm more care about. I mean, the designs, the details, and all the craftsmanship for the jewelry.
My name is Ilenia Corti, and I'm representing two brands. I'm the designer of two brands. One is called Sant'Agostino Fine Art Jewelry, and the other one is a new project called the Vernissage that is actually sold in the USA. One very colored and fancy and happy with the ladybugs and diamonds, very colored. And the other one is the dead opposite side of nature.
It's time for me to take a short break. I'm sure you can't wait to come back. Kyunki break ke baad hum dekhenge teen prominent designers at the Dubai Fashion Week. So stay with us. Fashion Week is more than just displaying the designs on the catwalk. It's a very important time for the designers to showcase their creation to set the tone for the upcoming season. So let's go to Dubai Fashion Week and check out the trends for Autumn Winter 2009. Talk with Lebanese born designer Walid Atalla, whose USP is an eclectic mix of East and the West. I've been holding out so long, I've been sleeping all alone. Lord, I miss you.
Dresses, 37 party dresses and 5 wedding dresses. It's I called it by lotus, flower lotus. It carries colors of black and light brown and yellow, red, gold and pink and purple. This collection is the last collection. I am the first time which I show it. I hope everybody will like it.
Parvesh and Jay have come together to create a brand called Parvesh Jay, and their label is already an international favorite. And they've designed for labels like Born Dutch and many more. Let's talk to them.
Was mainly inspired from Indian theme, like the Indian collection, the Indian colors, the silhouettes, the elements which was used, like it was totally Indian, the colors, the silhouettes, anything.
It was all inspired from a lot of feminism and a lot of femininity, and it was like you have attitude but very innocent attitude, not like attitude for heck of it. Basically it was inspired from the, like, you know, girlish phase of the women, like, you know, when they are innocent, they haven't learned the world kind of thing and all. And we have used a lot of drapes and a lot of like fabric formation is there in the garments.
See, we keep on coming with ideas for the autumn winter 09. This was our theme basically. So for this time, like according to the forecast and according to the things like which are around, like we decided to go for this Victorian look with the Indian touch.
Designer of Arab origin, Amir Ali's fascination for the female form has inspired his line of clothing called Dubai.Uma. Let's see his collection. Winter 2009, Dubai.Uma gave a standing ovation to the golden age of cinema and the starlets that encapsulated the era. With power, presence and Super Luke's attitude, the Dubai.Uma woman is today's screen siren distraction. She shuns moderation and indulges in fuchsia pink, heavy satins and golden silk velvets, clipped and strapped with crystal headbands, cuffs and bells. Floor-length 1930 silhouettes are underpinned with knitted silk catsuits and roll necks, talking the private world she inhabits and taking the garbo approach to socializing. This super fine woman still knows how to party, and her sexual prowess powerfully motivates her stride up the red carpet. This was my favorite collection at the Dubai Fashion Week. isn't it? Fashion weeks have a certain energy, a euphoria that not only inspires the designers to do their best, but also the viewers to look their best each and every day. We all love surprises, don't we? इसीलिए जब हमें एक surprise party का invitation मिला, तो हम बहुत excited थे. The venue was disclosed just 2 days before the party. Well, I'm talking about the Escada Beach Party. अब आप जरूर जानना चाहेंगे कि ये surprise party क्यों रखी गई थी. Beach party was organized at the Westin Hotel to launch Escada's new fragrance, Ocean Lounge. So let's witness the scent of a woman.
We are very excited about this. We have a new fragrance, Ocean Lounge, Escada Ocean Lounge. It's already in the market. Escada is a very, very unique brand to my heart. This is a new fragrance launched from the limited edition, the fashion fragrance, which we launch once every year. So people should grab one from the shelves very fast because they're running out. It's a fruity floral, very summery-like. It has a lot of exciting fruits in it. Strawberry meringue, it has lychee ingredients. Basically, this brings alive the perfect summer holiday concept.
Is great. The party has a very good atmosphere.
It's beautiful. It's just amazing. Great. It's great. It's just great.
Absolutely awesome. Needs to be a permanent thing though.
It's good. Very unexpected. I didn't realize so many people would arrive. It's really a big happening here.
In Germany we say beste Leben.
Well, as you can see, we really enjoyed the party and I also love the new fragrance. Right now it's time for us to move on to another segment, High Focus. हाई फोकस में हम हर हफ्ते उन इश्यूज को डिस्कस करते हैं जो हमारे लिए और हमारे सोसाइटी के लिए बहुत मायने रखते हैं. एंड दिस वीक वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट जुवेनाइल डायबिटीज.
Juvenile diabetes. You have a young son or daughter who has lost a lot of weight lately. In spite of that, the child has an increased hunger. Could there be something seriously wrong physically with your child? There might be. Doctors say whenever a young child loses weight for no apparent reason, that child should have a medical examination. Rapid weight loss is one of the first symptoms of diabetes, especially if the child also has increased hunger, even after eating. Other symptoms include frequent urination, dry mouth, fatigue, blurred vision and numbness or tingling of the hands or feet. Type 1 diabetes is called juvenile diabetes, as the onset of it begins in childhood. Children diagnosed with juvenile diabetes are insulin dependent. Insulin is the hormone that enables our body to convert the food we eat into energy, which is necessary to function normally. Juvenile diabetes in the UAE. Childhood diabetes in the UAE is mostly the unpreventable type 1 diabetes, but doctors have now reported seeing children as young as 10 with type 2 diabetes. Obesity is the main culprit in the development of type 2 diabetes, which is when the body becomes resistant to insulin and no longer able to convert sugar and starches into energy. A diabetes education and monitoring center dedicated to children and teens is opened in the UAE. The Juvenile Diabetes Education Center, set up by the Emirates Diabetes Society and Johnson & Johnson Corporate Trust in Dubai Healthcare City, provides free information and support services for children with type 1 diabetes between the ages of 4 and 18. The center, the first of its kind in the UAE, was established to help tackle the nation's rising diabetes rate.
With that, we come to the end of another exciting journey. Please keep writing to us and don't forget to visit our website to win loads of gifts. We had a rocking time putting this episode together. I hope you had fun too. See you next week only on High Life Dubai.